Hey guys, it's Damien.
And I'm Kennedy, and thank you so much for joining us. Remember, we do have our new book, Hashtag Completely Married, available on Amazon. The link is in the description.
So most of us have heard about the story in Genesis chapter 3 of the fall of man, where Satan actually tempted Eve, and Eve ate the fruit, and Eve gave the fruit to Adam. But we've always wondered, what about some of those details that are not in the Bible? Like, what type of fruit was it?
Better been something good, like a mango or
something. It had to be a mango, right?
or maybe a peach.
Or why Adam didn't just slap the fruit out of her hand? Like, get out of here. Or like, why did they not discuss before, you know, making that serious decision? So in this video, we really want to talk about how to handle serious decisions in marriage and in relationships, and how to have those tough conversations. And we want to have a disclaimer as well as to, we don't get it 100% right. However, we're going to provide biblical principles that we have applied to our relationship that has helped us as well.
Yeah. So number one, before making a serious decision, talk it over with your significant other or your spouse, or even your accountability partners if you are single. And so you never want to make a tough life-altering decision that will affect the other person without discussing it with them.
So good.
And sometimes this means doing it in private, because if someone else is there, it might alter the decision. And so those serious decisions and conversations can be handled in private. You also don't have to make the decision most times right then and there. Stepping away, deciding on it before actually making your decision. I know in the beginning of our marriage, I was horrible at this. I would make decisions, you know, immediately without talking with Damien. And sometimes even saying yes when he was right there without even like communicating with him. And so I had to change my mindset and remember that I'm no longer single, that I have to be considerate of him as well.
That's so good. Number two is reverence God. We want to make sure that our decision honors God. It needs to reverence God in every aspect. One of the things that we talk about is really having the fear of the Lord. Is this decision going to honor God and even obey his word? I love what Job 28:28 says. And it says, "Behold, the fear of the Lord, that is wisdom, and to turn away from evil is understanding." There's two questions that you can ask yourself today if you're going through a difficult decision or trying to handle a difficult decision. Number one, does this decision honor God's word? And number two, did God already say no to this decision?
So like if you're purchasing a new car, that God said no, get out of debt first. Let's honor him in that.
Yeah.
So number three is taking it to the Lord in prayer, especially in those decisions where you don't have to make it right then and there. Step away, pray individually and together to get more guidance from God. Also, we get to partner with the Holy Spirit. He is a counselor and comforter and helper. And so we can get insight and wisdom from the Holy Spirit. And so I also love what it says in Proverbs 3, 5, and 6, which is very familiar. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take. And so asking him for guidance and understanding in his will in our decision making, our everyday life.
And the last one, and this should make more sense because of the story in Genesis 3, is resist the enemy. Resist the enemy. In making your decisions, you want to resist the enemy. James 4:7 says, "So humble yourself before God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you." We have to silence the enemy in our lives. We know that we have those voices that are talking to us that tries to go against God's word. And like in Genesis chapter 3, we have to silence that temptation as well. 1 Corinthians 10:13 says, "No temptation has seized us what is common to man." God will always provide a way out. And so God is there to help us. And like Kennedy said, we have to engage the Holy Spirit into our spirits so we can resist the enemy. Also, in silencing the enemy, we need to silence the other voices. And maybe that means to pull away from people. Sometimes we have people in our lives who want us to go against God's word, and going back to our point, to disobey him. Mm-hmm. And so we need to come together as a unit and say, look, we're going to reverence God in everything we do.
Thank you, Damien, for those tips. And so that concludes our video. I hope this helped. You can like, share, and subscribe. And also you can follow us on Instagram at Damien and Kennedy. That's Damien and Kennedy spelled out. If you've already purchased the book, #completelymarried, we'd love to hear your thoughts on it. And please leave a review once you're finished. So again, I'm Kennedy. That's not how we do it.
My name is Damien Nash.
And I'm Kennedy Nash. And messing it up again.
And we'll see you next time. Bye.